So the second application I want to show is one built by a defense customer of us, which is Airbus Defense and Space. So what you see here on our screen is an application that they built to use in a military context to allow users to very easily request an airspace reservation. And that's what is called an ARES. So what the system does is it would take into account all the parameters of the request. So for example, what time of day you want to fly, where you want to fly, the region you want to fly, and so on. And this can be useful, for example, if you have a military training session with a fighter pilot to request an airspace and to avoid conflict with civil aviation. So let me show that on the screen. So by clicking this button, you get this UI. It allows you to give in the time when you want to fly. It allows you to give you the flight level, so the lower and the upper ones, the area of interest you want to fly, how many miles, width and length you want to have. And then when you submit that, the system automatically computes a region of airspace where it's safe to fly in that time range, in that altitude range. It's not just a 2D problem, although the map is 2D here. If I switch to 3D, and you can do that with the Lucia technology always on the fly, if I switch to 3D, you will see that there's no intersections with existing flight routes with other airspaces. So for example here, you see a couple other airspaces, there's no intersection. If you would do this manually, and you would place these things on the map, you would see that you easily get intersections between those the flights. Yeah. So this would be unsafe.
Yes.
So what the system does is it computes that automatically.
So does it give a signal that it's unsafe?
It would give you a message that it could not find a solution. So it would not propose an unsafe solution. In this case, the way that if you do it manually, the way you see that it's unsafe, you see that it lists the conflicts on the side. Now, this is now a 3D computation. It's a 3D optimization problem. But in fact, you can be less restrictive because if you look at those flight routes or flight plans, the flight itself will not be necessarily at the exact same time as the airspace reservation in this airspace region. So actually, you can make this a 4D optimization problem. And in 4D, you see there's many more solutions to the problem. So what you see now is you see only the airspaces and the parts of the flight plans that correspond to the time range of this reservation. And then the operator can start moving around in time and see that it's still okay to fly at certain times. But you see, for example, if you move the time here, you see that you get more and more flight plans that overlap with this time plan. So it could be that in a certain moment in time you don't have a conflict, but at a certain other moment in time you do have conflicts.